Continuing the conversation about analyzing pipes in parallel, let's consider this example where there's an 800 gallon per minute flow entering a flow split. Pipe 1 is 8 inches and has a length of 1400 feet and a C value of 100, while pipe 2 has a diameter of 10 inches and runs a length of 950 feet with a C value of 120. The objective here is to find the flow rate in pipe 1 and pipe 2. We have a couple tools we can use to help us do this. First, we know that the head loss in pipe 1 is equal to the head loss in pipe 2. Also, we know that the flow rate in pipe 1 plus the flow rate in pipe 2 is equal to the original 800 gallon per minute flow rate entering the flow split. So let's start the analysis by writing the head loss in pipe 1 equal to the head loss in pipe 2 using the Hazen-Williams equation. This format of the equation uses the unit head loss formula, but then adds back in the length of the pipeline. All of the information inside these blue dotted lines are characteristics of the pipe itself, which includes the roughness, diameter, and the length of the pipeline. We can isolate this in a calculation to simplify the algebra later. Inserting the actual values for pipe 1, we get 148 divided by 100 times 8 to the 2.63 power, that whole quantity to the 1.85 power, and then we multiply that by the length of the pipeline of 1400 feet divided by 1000 feet. That I compute as 1.2 times 10 to the minus 4th. We do this again for the pipe number 2, and insert the specific values as 148 divided by 120 times 10 to the 2.63, that quantity to the 1.85 power, times the length 950 divided by 1,000. I compute this as 1.9 times 10 to the minus 5th, and I can rewrite that as 0.19 times 10 to the minus 4th so that it matches up with the value that we got for pipe 1 a little better. We set the two pipes equal to each other to get 1.2 times Q in pipe 1 to the 1.85 power equal to 0.19 times Q in pipe 2 to the 1.85 power. Solving for the flow rate in pipe 1, we get that equal to 1.85 root of 0.19 divided by 1.2 times the flow rate in pipe 2. And that gets us P1 equal to 0.37 times pipe 2. We plug this equation back into our original continuity equation where Q is equal to pipe 1 plus the flow rate in pipe 2. And we solve for the flow rate in pipe 2 as equal to the total Q divided by 1 plus 0.37, and that gives us 584 gallons per minute. Plugging that value back into our continuity equation, we get the flow rate in pipeline is equal to 0.37 times the flow rate in pipe 2, which is equal to 0.37 times 584 gallons per minute, or in other words, 216 gallons per minute for the flow rate in pipe 1.